just underway. Iowa State, having won 22 consecutive at home, hosting Kansas, and you just saw the game's first field goal as it is put up by Kevin Young, the veteran wingman here for the Jayhawks, and that quiets the crowd for the time being. But if you have not seen a game in this building, it has become, as Fred Hoiberg has coached the Cyclones back to relevance, one of the best settings in all of college basketball. They live by the three. Will Clyburn, the transfer from Utah. I'm Brett Musburger with Fran Fraschilla. Holly Rowe is alongside, and this is going to be some showdown here tonight, Fran.
Absolutely. Contrasting styles. A lot of threes from Cyclones.
That's a foul against the Jayhawks. There are our starting lineups. The four seniors for the Jayhawks and the very talented redshirt freshman Ben McLemore, Lucius Babb, Clyburn, Niang. They will start alongside Edgem for the Cyclones.
One of the keys, Brent, for the Cyclones is going to be try to get Jeff Withey away from the basket.
So you can see our score is 3-2. Is that field goal did not count because of the foul outside. Young again misses this time. Lucius, the transfer from Michigan State, comes to the attack.
Well, they're playing off of Young, giving him that shot so they can help inside on Whitney.
And Self gets teed up by Mark Whitehead very early. Called a foul on Elijah Johnson, and Self is livid. I have never seen Bill Self draw a technical this early in a game, Fran. And he's still going at him.
Bill Self is very measured usually. You just wonder if this is just sending a message to the officials, but this is a veteran crew.
Now, Whitehead, who called the tee, is with Tom O'Neill and Bert Smith. So Lucius misses on the first one. Now watch the top of your screen and see what kind of contact. There's the whistle and Self all over Whitehead at the technical. And Lucius comes back and hits the second one.
Well, you just wonder if Bill Self knows how hostile this place will be tonight. And either he's trying to get his team going or just trying to send a message to the officials that he's here to fight for his team.
Babb has to pick it up. Edgem is number three. Tap in is good. And a very athletic Melvin Edgem from Toronto followed it up and slammed it home.
And you saw Niang took Withey away from the basket. That's what they're going to try to do tonight to Kansas.
Withey wants to back down, and there's a pushing foul down on the inside on Niang. George Niang, their 6'7 freshman, who Withey has become, Fran, in my opinion, one of the best players in the country. I honestly believe he's the most valuable player in the Big 12. Now, I didn't say he was the best.
I just said
he's the most valuable. And then underneath, Young working away again, and that's two field goals for him, all four of their points.
Well, Niang is a very effective post player because he can stretch you with the three.
On the drive is Lucius.
This is why they call it a spread offense, Brent, because five guys out there for the Cyclones can shoot the three. They're going to force Withey and Young away from the basket tonight.
Fred Hoiberg, an Ames, Iowa legend, has come home. His nickname, the Mayor. And what a remarkable turnaround. This is his third year. Went to the NCAAs last year, and they're headed there again. Johnson muscles, has to give it. Young, very active, won't stay down, knocked away from Withey. And there is Young, extremely active. Johnson's three ball is good.
That's important. Elijah Johnson has come out of his shooting funk last three games.
And Lucius comes right back down. Anytime, any place in the shot clock count for the Cyclones with the three. And Withey, and that's where they'd love to keep him tonight, is out there shooting long shots like that, Fran.
Well, that's exactly right. Here's another three, Brent.
Knocked back down by Niang. George Niang. Iowa State on fire.
You're watching ESPN's Bracket Builder Week.
Hilton Magic, they call it here at Ames, and Bill Self all over his team for the lack of defense on the threes. They stressed it in the shoot-around today, Fran.
Well, that's what makes Iowa State so difficult to guard, Brent, and it can be a matchup problem for Kansas with the inside.
Now Relaford responds, so he knocks down a three. Now Iowa State against the Jayhawks defense, they've hit 3 of 4 from three-point range.
Well, this is all about getting Jeff Withey away from the basket if they can. There's another opportunity.
Not this time. At Johnson with the defensive rebound. He's got Relaford on the move. Right baseline, and a foul is going to go against Iowa State. Looks like that foul was against Lucius. We'll take a break and be right back. Presented by Bud Light. It's part of Bracket Builder Week, and we think we've got a great setting and a great game for you here tonight with the Kansas Jayhawks visiting Iowa State. Fran, it was interesting. Jeff Withey's only field goal attempt of this game was on the outside, and you were talking to coaches and everything. They'd love to keep Withey outside if they can.
Absolutely. He's averaging 17-9 in the last four wins for Kansas, but conversely, for Iowa State, it's about getting him away from the basket. And let's show you what we mean by spread pick and roll, Brent, and why Iowa State is so dangerous. They put four shooters on the floor, really five with Niang. But when Niang screens, he's going to roll to the rim, and you'll see the Baylor defender has to soften up and absorb the cutter, and that opens up the three for Melvin Edgem. Now, early in this game, watch Niang outside on the perimeter. He's got Withey away from the basket, drives by, and here comes the tip in from the weak side. So far, the strategy working well for Fred Hoiberg.
And we come back with Relaford on the free throw line. Remember, he was attacking the baseline. He was fouled on the shot. So he has one more free throw. As we check in on one-on-one, you can see how tough defensively the Jayhawks have been this season. And the Cyclones, as we told you, live by that three, and Relaford leaves 2 points on the table that time.
Well, this Cyclone team is making more than 10 threes a game in conference play.
Niang, a quick pump fake, and back from the corner comes still another three. Defensive rebound is Young. Now Elijah Johnson attacks. Drives in for a fine layup, and it's a two-point game. And now Fred Hoiberg questioning something with Whitehead.
Well, that's really important for Elijah Johnson to get going. We've chronicled his shooting slump for much of this year, but in the last few games that Kansas has played very, very well, Elijah Johnson has risen up, much like he did last year as a junior in helping Kansas get to the Final Four.
Relaford got a hand on it. Saved over there by Babb. No foul called this time. Babb, now he steps out. Chris Babb, 6'5", senior from Arlington, Texas. So that inside-outside game. Attack and then pass it back. This time Lucius fires up a bit of an air ball, and Johnson's got it, and now the Jayhawks are looking for a tie or the lead. Johnson going to attack again on the dribble. Tap back, Young's got it, his third field goal of the game. Deadlocked at 14.
All started because Elijah Johnson's been very aggressive early in this game. A good sign for Kansas.
The runner, they stuck back again by Melvin Edgem. That's the second time he's got to the rim.
And the reason he's getting there, Brent, is Withey is away from the rim, guarding Niang at 19 feet away.
Just what you said, if they can keep him on the outside. And that's Hoiberg's strategy. Something obviously you learn from all those quality coaches in the NBA. Relaford, in and out, battle rebound, goes out of bounds. And it's going to be Jayhawk basketball.
Well, there you see Withey is out at the three-point line. Niang does a nice job of getting it on the rim. And there's Edgem, the leading rebounder in the Big 12 at only 6'6".
So Self is going to go a little small here to counter that. He's going to take Withey out in the early going to see if he can put some more chasers on the floor. McLemore comes out with him right now. So Traylor has checked into the game, and Tharp will work in that backcourt alongside Elijah.
Little zone now by Iowa State, 2-3.
Rutherford couldn't feed it into the post. Stepping out is Traylor, and now here's Tharp. Good ball movement. Rutherford on the attack. Tap back is good.
Now, there's an Achilles heel for the Cyclones. They have not defended well in Big 12 play. They like to outscore teams.
Tharp is on Lucius. And an offensive rebound. Putback is no good. Traylor muscling for the rebound is knocked away from him. And out of bounds, it will be Cyclone ball.
Brent, think of Iowa State's offense as the spread offense in football. One of the reasons Jeff Withey is having trouble, he's like a linebacker trying to guard a wide receiver, and that's why Bill Self has gone small.
And, of course, it's to Iowa State's advantage to keep Withey over there on the bench. Last week's co-Big 12 Player of the Week for the second time this season. And he was a force in that overtime win for Kansas earlier this season in Lawrence against Iowa State. Attacking and back up to the free throw line.
You see in Iowa State not necessarily rely on the three, but the threat of the three has really opened up their driving game.
So Chris Babb comes to the free throw line. The Jayhawks must win tonight to stay deadlocked with Kansas State. Kansas State, after being in a tough game with Texas Tech for one half, exploded in the second half. And now their record goes to 12-3. Oklahoma State, Iowa State, Oklahoma all seem to be locks as far as the NCAA tournament is concerned. But Baylor has still got some work to do. Tharp will bring it up and operate at the point.
They're still not guarding Kevin Young at the high post, even with Withey out of the game.
Traylor steps out. Now McLemore is back on the floor. Tharp pulls the trigger. They let him shoot. They were not that concerned. And Tyrus McGee, perhaps the best six man in the conference, on transition, missed the shot.
Now, I think this is a situation where Ben McLemore has already passed up a couple of scoring opportunities. He needs him to be their alpha dog.
Instead, it's Johnson who's the alpha dog, along with Young here tonight. Johnson puts him into the lead, 18-17, leading the way with 7 points. Loose ball. And reaching back was Paolo. Puba Paolo. Picked up the personal foul. Now Withey will come back. There are 4 Jayhawk fouls here and 3 against Iowa State in the first half.
I don't want to say that early technical foul was premeditated, but it sort of almost calmed this crowd down. And it certainly calmed this Kansas team down. They've played very good basketball and taken the crowd out of it.
Elijah Johnson off to a big time start.
See how Niang is basically double-teaming inside.
Babb is staying with him. And that was a fine three-pointer by Tharp. So Tharp, too, contributing. And that backcourt has been the difference here as far as the Jayhawks are concerned.
They're going to go check the clock. Brent, it froze for a few seconds.
So this veteran officiating crew is over on the far side taking a look at it.
Well, Kevin Young has given Bill Self a really good first few minutes, and they're not playing him on the perimeter, but consequently he's able to get to the rim with some easy baskets around the rim.
Now it'll lock up at 12-12. I still think he would have got it off in time. Do you agree with that?
Yes. I
think,
yeah.
No? We'll see. I'm sure they're overchecking. When you you've got magic in your court, it's always good to control the clock.
I was just thinking, we got a chance to see the great couple opening minutes where this crowd was electric, but Bill Self's team has quieted the crowd.
Now they got the stopwatch out across the way. And we'll see how far they brought it down. So once they take the 10 seconds off, that field goal is still good. So it becomes a media timeout now. And we'll take a break with the Jayhawks leading it by 4.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go.
We welcome you back to Ames, Iowa. Ben McLemore, who lit Iowa State up with 33 over in Lawrence. And Holly Rowe, he is 0 of 1 here tonight.
Well, this has been a little bit of a trend that's been developing for the freshmen on the road in Big 12 games. At home, Ben McLemore is averaging 21 points a game, but on the road in conference games, just 12 points a game. His shooting numbers are also very down. His three-point shooting, 60% at home, just 22% on the road. I talked to him today at shoot-around about it. He said, I feel like when I'm on the road, I go too fast. Everything's happening fast. I've got to slow down, take my time tonight. But, guys, he's also got to be a little bit more aggressive, just one shot so far.
Yeah, McLemore and Withy have not scored in this game, but Relaford and along with Young and also Elijah Johnson have led the scoring.
Well, it's interesting. On the road in first halves in the Big 12, Kansas only scores 28 points and shoots 36%, so they need McLemore to get going.
Now here's McGee. He's a fine scorer after that timeout. Came off a curl for his first field goal, and it's 21-19.
Yeah, he's their second leading scorer, Brent. He's very comfortable coming off the bench. You mentioned it, one of the best shooters in this conference.
Tharp gets the ball to Withy against a smaller man, kicks it back outside, and Johnson misfiring. Great position on that rebound for Niang, the 6'7 freshman.
Now let's see now if Iowa State can spread. No, they're going to keep shooting those threes.
And yep. Why not? Yep. Anthony Booker, the 6'9 senior from St. Louis, puts the Cyclones back ahead.
And once again, he put Withy in jail. Not sure whether to guard him or back off and play the rim.
Withy being fronted in underneath. Johnson, not this time. And Traylor knew that the ball was going back out of bounds. Great hustle that time by the freshman out of bounds as the ball was going.
Well, watch this now, Brent. Watch. Withy's just playing back, not thinking that Booker's going to shoot it. A rhythm three. And another opportunity for Iowa State to use that three-point line to space the floor.
Lucius gets over. He just checked back in for Hoiberg. Knocked the ball out of bounds and away from Tharp.
Now it's hard to believe, Brent, but Kansas has only led in the first half of Big 12 games three times in seven games.
Clyburn back in off the Iowa State bench also. McLemore. Tough shot under pressure. Not that time. Hoisted up an air ball.
Anthony Booker so far doing a really good job of shadowing Withy without fouling. And they usually play zone underneath.
19 seconds on the shot clock here. Withy on a catch, and he traveled. Traveling on the inbounds pass. So on the turnover, it will go to the Cyclones. They lead it by a point.
You see how they spread the floor. Four round one.
Niang on a pick and roll, comes inside on Young, and he's going to be on the free throw line.
Great example of a screen and a slip to the rim. And I love this young guy, Brent. George Niang, watch the hands here. This pass is not on target by Lucius, but Niang comes up with a nice catch. He played high school basketball with Nerlens Noel at Tilton School. And he told me today, I learned how to get my shot off against a guy that's one of the premier shot blockers in college basketball this year until he got hurt.
He's at Kentucky, of course, and lost for the season with the knee injury when he ran into the basket support. Young, by the way, has picked up two fouls now. And so Niang here on the free throw line. You watch that pick and roll, Fran, and in practice today for Iowa State. And no surprise, Hoiberg, having spent year after year in the NBA, that is a staple of the Cyclones' attack. If they're not shooting threes, they're going to set up, they're going to isolate, and they're going to run pick and rolls.
Oh, that's right. You got to pick your poison when you guard them because they can get into the lane.
Ellis has checked in. Tharp, loose ball picked up by Ellis. Ellis couldn't score. Loose. Booker's got it. Here come the Cyclones. They withstood that assault. 24-21. Rebounding an issue. The Cyclones have to hustle to get rebounds. McGee with a good pump fake almost drew Rutherford to a foul. Three ball from Booker. Tracked down by Ellis.
I think that time Booker had to shoot a contested shot. He would have been better off faking and reversing that ball.
Stepping out now is McLemore. He's being hounded. Now it's Clyburn's turn on him. Withey on the free throw line. And the one thing Jeff Withey could do is shoot good free throws. And that's what keeps him on the floor, especially late in close basketball games. He becomes a huge factor.
Take a look, and now Withey gets deep position right here. Booker's done a good job to this point. Booker did a good job there. That time Jeff Withey initiated the contact. I thought Booker was solid defensively. You made that point, Brent. His first 2 years, Jeff Withey shot 54% from the foul line, and I think you mentioned how much Danny Manning worked with him during that junior year. He was up around 80 last year, still hovering around 70.
Danny, of course, no longer on the Kansas staff. He's now the head coach at Tulsa. He led the Jayhawks to a 1988 national championship. They beat the Sooners of Oklahoma in Kansas City. So he makes both free throws. We got a one-point game.
But never won in Hilton Coliseum. How about that?
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah. Johnny Orr had some great teams.
McGee's three. What a shooter. Dead eye, McGee.
As good as there is in this conference and probably a coast to coast. Young man from Stringtown, Oklahoma. 400 people live in Stringtown.
Where is Stringtown?
It's south of Tulsa. It's the home of Reba McEntire.
Oh, bye. I knew you'd know that.
Yep.
Good left-handed hook shot there, friend. Some good tunes out of Reba.
Yep.
You can sit and listen to her and drink a cold beer.
Remember UL Washington of the Kansas City Royals? Also his hometown.
Here comes Clyburn now, the transfer from Utah. Kick back outside. Short that time, and here come the Jayhawks. Looking for a tire or lead. McLemore on the move. Fade, left baseline. Can't get it to fall. Rutherford, good hustle rebound. Feed Withey again. Backing in, spinning, and he's back on that free throw line. So when we talk about six men, Fran, the one thing that you want from somebody like McGee is instant offense, and he gives it to him.
Absolutely. Take a look at that stroke. Bottom of the net.
We've got a timeout at 7:53.
Davis with you. Kansas State got a win over Texas Tech tonight. Now, Angel Rodriguez is going to hit a three, but I want you to watch Bruce Weber. Watch him will this one in. Oh! Little side bend for Bruce. Got it in. Rodriguez finished with 16, 75, 55. The final, Kansas State, temporarily at least, alone in first place in the Big 12. Villanova coming off a win over Marquette over the weekend on top of Seton Hall on ESPNU by a bucket.
And here, Iowa State leading Kansas 27-25. Fred Hoiberg, an Ames, Iowa native in his third season as the head coach, with Jeff Withey coming back to the free throw line. Number 32 retired here. The third all-time scoring leader. With the bounces in, his wife Carol here in the stands. She too is a native of Ames. They have four children right alongside to her right. There's a son, a daughter, and the twins over there on all the left. Those are the four Hoiberg children.
All pretty good shooters, those boys. I watched them yesterday, Brent. Take after their dad, who had a 10-year career cut short in the NBA by a heart surgery.
He's had a pacemaker installed. He always watches how he behaves on the sideline, tries to keep things under control, and he's just done a fabulous job here as head coach. Johnson comes down, lays it, and it's blocked from behind. Edgem got a hand on it and blocked it. And on the other side, a foul is going to be called against Relaford.
I think Iowa State fortunate. Clyburn there looked like he shuffled the feet before the contact. But watch Melvin Edgem, 6 foot six, leads the conference in rebounding, 12 double doubles on the year. Undersized, but not under heart.
There's McGee again. Gotta get somebody on him.
I'm telling you, Brent, I've watched this kid for 2 years. There's not many better shooters in all of college basketball.
Withy has the last 4 points for Kansas. Five, let's make it now, because he hit that other free throw. And Johnson was attacking, thought he could tap it in. So the Jayhawks trying to stay alive here at the free throw line.
Good wrinkle right there. Elijah Johnson usually fades to the wing, but that time his route took him to the rim. A set play, a wrinkle that they put in late in the season.
So the freshman sensation, Niang, with the two fouls on the Iowa State bench here with 7 minutes to go in the first half. Tharp will replace McLemore, and McLemore, remember, lit up Iowa State and Lawrence for 33. He simply cannot get it going. He's 0 for 3. And again, Holly Rowe told you about his problem scoring on the road. Johnson knocks down the free throw to make this a 2-point game.
Watch this, Brent. Right now, Edgem's the 5, Clyburn's the 4. They are really small. Let's see how Withy handles this.
Lucius, transfer from Michigan State, handling the ball out on top against Tharp. Kicks back Babb, the three ball. No, tap back, and over the back that time was Edgem. So finally they get position, and Edgem, who jammed in a couple of them, picks up his second foul. That is a big foul.
Well, both he and Niang now will likely sit. Take a look now. Jeff Withy on that weak side, and Edgem just goes over his back, and it's an easy call. But good effort by the young man. Played his high school at Brewster Academy, the same place, teammate of Thomas Robinson, Nadir Tharp. And Coach Smith up there does a tremendous job at developing these guys.
Missing that time. Booker wraps it up for Iowa State with a 2-point lead, 6.5 minutes, and here they come. Lucius drives in on Withy, gets past him and scores.
You can see it, Brent. Jeff Withy right now is a man on an island. Not comfortable away from the basket. Lucius just took him on at the top of the key.
Watching a game plan unfold here on the part of Iowa State, and so far it's been a success. Johnson kicks back, Tharp, three ball. No. Withy yanks down a rebound, puts it back up, and that's where he is so dangerous.
Yes, he is, and he is giving Bill Self a great effort on the offensive glass, offensive side of the ball.
So what would you do, Fran, when they try to pull your big man out? Would you go to a 2-3? I don't know that Kansas plays that much zone.
Only when Kansas gets down do they play those jump defenses.
Look at that. Hoiberg wants a timeout immediately. With 32-30, 5.5 minutes, Fran.
Well, take a look. Missed shot. Nadir Tharp, we've seen him give Bill Self that boost of energy all year. On the money to Relaford. They're back in it.
Now our score is 32 all. 5:39 remaining here on that last field goal. It did not take Hoiberg long to get the timeout called after that.
Now, these two teams combined for a lot of points in that first meeting that Kansas won in overtime.
17 fouls on both Kansas and Iowa State. On the drive, Clyburn, yes. Puts the Hawkeye, I should say, the Cyclones back up.
Well, you see what happens, Brent, when you stretch the defense and play the three-point line. Iowa State comfortable taking it right to the rim. Clyburn, the Utah transfer.
Want to go over the top now to Withy, and he couldn't hang on. Five Kansas turnovers.
Well, Brent, the execution was poor, but Bill Self put Travis Relaford in the high post, and they're not going to have to bet. They're not going to be able, Iowa State, to back off Relaford.
Booker on that high pick and roll. Lucius keeps it outside. Dab now feeds Booker. Withy's on him. Backing him down. Comes around the right way. Pretty good post move. Booker got inside for the offensive rebound. Slapped away and a foul. Is that McLemore who got him underneath? He was there.
Well, Anthony Booker has given Fred Hoiberg a good effort, especially on the offensive glass. Looked like Nadir got him there, and I think, who was it, McLemore? Tharp?
They gave Tharp the foul on it. They apparently had called for the foul a little bit earlier than that, when he slapped it out. Well, two great matchups. The Bracket Builder Week on Tuesday. Indiana will take on Minnesota. Minnesota needs another quality win. Started out red hot. Then Florida and Tennessee. And Frank, you were telling me the Gators have a chance to be one of the number one seeds now, perhaps down south.
They are as efficient on both offense and defense as most any team in the country. Put Indiana at the top of that list.
Listen to the crowd, ladies and gentlemen.
Withy's got more room inside now.
Over Booker's head, and they give it right back. This crowd would have exploded if they'd hit that layup.
I think Clyburn felt that Booker should have been looking. Freddie Hoiberg said, easy, easy.
Yeah, you don't want to point that out to a teammate out on the floor. You might want to talk about it when you're looking at film privately. You don't want to try to show up your teammate on the other end. It was a dangerous pass at best.
Well, Kansas has matched down and gone small, and so they've got some firepower.
Ball thought comes away with it. Withy steps back out, and here's Johnson now. Relaford with the high screen. Back in low. Withy muscles on Booker. Fine field goal for Jeff Withy. 9 points here tonight, 3 of 5 from the field. Lucius gets help from Booker. Now he'll give it back to him, and Booker's going to try the three. No. Kansas basketball looking for a tie or a lead.
And Booker's getting a little bit three happy right now.
Tharp loses control. Withy picks it up. Withy gives it back now to Tharp. They play catch. The three ball's good. And the Jayhawks lead at 37-36 on Tharp's three ball.
Ever since Kansas has gone small, Withy has had more room inside, but it's now opened up the perimeter.
And a big move by Self is putting Tharp on the point and Johnson at the shooting guard. Back outside. Not this time. Booker, though, had it come right to his hands after the miss by McGee. Lucius fouled by Tharp. We'll take a break at the 240. Mark over the limit, remember. Jayhawks up by one, but the Cyclones will have a chance to do something about it when you come back.
I'm Reese Davis. UPS Halftime Report coming up. Yet another milestone for Brittany Griner, and yet another win for her Baylor Bears. We'll show you what Baylor's big post person did against OU coming up in a bit. Syracuse and Marquette, a little home cooking for the Golden Eagles, and one big guy that went off for a career night. And we'll put Georgetown in the court vision and show you why the Hoyas might be emerging as the best team in the Big East. Streaking Hoyas, Jay and Seth. Halftime's coming up, Brett.
All right, Reese, thank you. And Kansas shooting 46.7%. Iowa State's 41.4%. Iowa State's hit 6 of 15 from three-point range. Remember, they hit three of their first four. And now they come to the free throw line, and they tie it at 37.
Take a look at Jeff Withey. He's got more room to operate now, Brent, because Bill Self has taken Kevin Young out of the lineup, gone four guards. And so the perimeter's a threat. Withey has more room.
And Holly, what did Coach Self have to say in the huddle?
Well, Fran, he agrees with you. He said, hey, we got to throw it to Jeff every single time. They recognize the advantage that they have size-wise right now. In that last huddle, he drew up about three different plays, all for Withey. We'll see if they can get it to him.
Well, they're instead, they missed from three-point range with Elijah. Withey has nine of Kansas' last 16 points. But the whistle here is going to go against the Cyclones.
Well, those plays he drew up, Brent, are not going to work likely against the 2-3 zone because Fred Hoiberg, understanding Withey was hurting them, has gone to the zone. And he's got to milk that clock with Niang and Edgem on the bench.
They get it to Withey's hands, but not where Kansas wants him positioned now. And 2:14 left here in the first half. McLemore very, very quiet here so far tonight. And there, McLemore hits his first field goal of the game with 1:59 remaining in the first half, and he puts the Jayhawks up by one.
Did a nice job of slipping into the high post off that zone. Tharp found him.
McLemore taking Clyburn, bringing some seconds off the clock. Clyburn wants a clear out, wants to go. State kicks it back. Babb under pressure. Bring him to the free throw line. Johnson coming in behind him. Johnson picked up the personal foul, and that will put Babb on the free throw line here with Iowa State down by a point. NBA Wednesday, doubleheader on ESPN, 8 Eastern. Warriors will take on the Knicks, 10:30 Eastern. Nuggets will face the Blazers. NBA Wednesday is presented by State Farm.
Well, this young man, Chris Babb, a Penn State transfer, but he knows Kansas basketball very well. His dad and his uncles, terrific players in the state of Kansas from Topeka. Dad's got a great barbecue place in Dallas.
And we had some good barbecue today, didn't we, Carmen, at the Hickory?
Yes, we did. Hickory Park. Little zone now. Trying to keep that ball away from Withey.
Tharp wanted to get it back to him at a pick and roll. He does late, and that could be offense, yes. That's two fouls on Withey. And Coach Self's going to give him a break.
It's a tough play here for Withey because Tharp gives it to him on the move, and that's not what I would do if I were playing with the seven-footer. You could say Withey could have pulled up, but Tharp needs to know the defense was set.
And that was Will Clyburn, the transfer from Utah, who's set to take that foul. Iowa State up a point. This is Clyburn offensively. Come off shot fake. Air ball. McLemore rebounds. And now the last minute, the Jayhawks can take the lead. Traylor back on the floor.
Chris Babb's done a terrific job shadowing McLemore.
Traylor steps out, not to be. One and done, and here come the Cyclones inside of a minute now. Lucius will give it back on the outside. Fred Hoiberg signaled, bring it down now to one.
Clyburn can really handle it, and Fred Hoiberg's going to exploit the mismatch if he can with Ellis. Self-coaching Ellis, telling him to back off.
He's going to bring it down inside of 10. Now Hoiberg wants him to go. He does. Not to be. Offensive rebound. Loose ball picked up. Jayhawks, they've got 9 seconds. Plenty of time. Here comes Tharp. Tharp will drive it hard and lay it in. 41-40 Kansas on a fine drive by Tharp. Let's check in now with Holly and Coach Hoiberg.
Well, Coach, it seems like you're trying to be creative in how you handle the mismatch with Jeff Withey. What did you think worked the best? Going small, zone, what helped?
Well, I think the big thing we have to do is really get compacted in there and build that wall. I thought Booker gave us good minutes in there by getting into his body. We just got to do a better job. You know, I thought George was straight up on a couple of those. We just got to do a better job. We know they're going to go inside on us.
You play a good half, but how frustrating was it for you to give a layup there as time's winding down?
Well, yeah, it's frustrating. You know, I thought, you know, Will had a little bit of a mismatch there with Ellis Garden. We tried to flatten out the floor and let him go to work. They made a good defensive play and got a run out on it.
Thanks, Coach.
So Iowa State gives up the lead at the very end of the game. And you can see the three-point shooting tonight. Now let's go to Reese Davis, Seth Greenberg, and Jay Williams with the UPS halftime report. Take it away, Reese.
All right, Brent, you know who the biggest Iowa State fans in the world are tonight? Kansas State fans, but that's probably anytime somebody's playing Kansas. But it would also help the Wildcats. They could be alone in first place in the Big 12, taking on Texas Tech. This was a one-point game at halftime. Look at Nino Williams. El Nino!
Poor transition defense right there. A strong finish at the rim.
Now, I want you to watch this shot. No. Don't put the graphic up in front.
He gave up with a little English.
That is an error in the control room, and I never call out the guys who always make us look good. But let me tell you what Bruce Weber did on that shot. Angel Rodriguez knocked it down. Show him, Seth.
Okay, let's get back on defense.
He kind of willed it in. Kansas State won it 75-55. Okay, now. I've got a little message before we talk about this first half. All you people in the Big East, Big Ten, a lot of teams in the SEC, it's just not that hard. Let's play the way Iowa State and Kansas are playing. 41-40 at halftime. A lot of great offense. This is what we want to see.
Jay Will can play in this game.
I would love to play for Fred Hoiberg and the way they play. Their space out defense, and it's making it so difficult for guys to really guard them on the perimeter. And, you know, Withey right here, he's being exposed in this basketball game. He is not used to guarding the likes of Niang on the perimeter. A one-on-one isolation. Look at the spread of the floor. He's able to get a shot at the rim. Kevin Young needs to come over. Melvin Edgem right there. He averages 12.5 rebounds per game in the last two games. Once again, ball gets rotated over. And Kevin, Jeff Withey isn't even getting out there, right? Anthony Booker, hand down, man down, as Mark Jackson would say, knocks down a three-point shot. How could you not want to play for Fred Hoiberg? Listen, they're not going to out-execute this basketball team. They're not going to out-defend them. They're going to try to outscore.
I love the spacing that Iowa State plays with. What it does, not only offensively spreads the floor to drive it and kick it, but it gives you angles to offensive rebound. When you're undersized, it gives you a chance to get to the offensive glass and score some easy baskets. But if I'm Kansas, I'm feeling pretty good about myself. Ben McLemore, 2 points. Elijah Johnson, solid first half going to the basket. Nadir Tharp. If I'm Bill Self, after the technical, I feel pretty good about myself.
And no kidding, especially, too, the way Iowa State shot in the first half. No, by the way, it is Kansas that's on top. I'm also okay playing for Bill Self and the way they play.
Agree.
Up and down. Made baskets. What a great thing. Made baskets. There were some made baskets by one big fella on Big Monday earlier, Marquette and Syracuse. Where do you see what Devontae Gardner did against the Orange? Tough-minded Big East game. And could it be that the best team in the Big East is now Georgetown, who's already lost to the worst team in the Big East? We'll talk about the change when you come back.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Taco Bell. Sometimes you gotta live Moss. And Samuel Adams, for the love of beer.
Welcome back to Big Monday, presented by Bud Light. It's part of Bracket Builder Week with Fran Fraschilla. I'm Brett Musburger, and Jeff Withey has been a story at both ends of the court here so far.
Well, he has. He's a big part of Iowa State's game plan, Brent, because Fred Hoiberg has tried to take him away from the basket, and I think with pretty good results. Anthony Booker knocks down the three. Corey Lucius comes off that ball screen, attacks Withey, gets to the rim, and then watch this one. Niang is going to catch that ball. It's not so much that he drives by Withey, but look where Melvin Edgem is, the best rebounder in the Big 12. He gets a running start to the rim and cleans up the miss. Now on the other end, Jeff Withey, 9 points. And you can bet that Bill Self is going to try to build that offense around him in the second half.
And we should point out that with 3.5 minutes remaining in the first half, Iowa State had a 7-point lead, and they let it get away from them in the closing minutes here.
No, they did. Jeff Withey played inside. Bill Self went small, and their guards did a good job of spacing, but also getting into the big guy. They'll do more of that.
Well, we'll take a look at some of the numbers here from the first half. Note the players with 2 fouls. We have 6 of them, and there was a technical called on Coach Bill Self, and Fran thought it was to stir up the team. What did you learn about that, Holly?
Well, I asked Coach Self about it at the half, and he said, I thought our team needed a little something, so I did that on purpose. He actually winked to the crowd after he got that technical foul. Guys, I also checked in with him about when Iowa State goes small, how does that affect Kansas? He said, well, it actually forces us to go small because our bigs aren't used to guarding on the perimeter that much.
Withey steps out, and this time he knocks down the field goal for Withey now. 11 points, the first double-digit score of the night for the Jayhawks, and they build a 3-point lead here.
Again, the game plan is for Iowa State to spread the floor, attack those bigs.
Lucius was the leading scorer for Iowa State. Drive, tap back, no, loose, battle for it, play a little volleyball, it goes over to the Jayhawks.
Well, good effort by Edgem to get to the rim. He got by Kevin Young, couldn't finish it.
Edgem had 2 fine jams, but that was all in the first half. And he, too, is playing with 2 fouls. Edgem spent a lot of time on the bench, as did Niang, who opens up the second half. Great steal by Clyburn. The transfer. And the foul is on Relaford.
And they're going to get him for intentional foul. Flagrant 1, 2 free throws in the ball. Take a look. Sloppy reversal by Johnson. Clyburn is taken off, and then you see Relaford didn't play the ball. Burt Smith, the official, right there. Now, we were talking, Brent, right before the second half started. Bill Self would love to get an 8-point lead and try to get this crowd out of the game. On the other hand, this Hilton Magic crowd, once Iowa State starts to get in the rhythm, this place will become electric.
They've won 22 consecutive games here in Ames, the third longest home court winning streak in the country right now.
Watch Lucius here.
Niang, the freshman, backs down on Withey, jumps up over and couldn't get the roll. Young rebounds. McLemore, very quiet in the first half. Withey, double teamed, and it's a held ball, and it will stay with the Jayhawks.
Well, what you love about that is Fred Hoiberg didn't double Withey too often in the first half, changed up his scheme, and came quickly with Edgem.
Hoiberg learned under some fine coaches in his college career, and again in the NBA. McLemore forces one up, and he fouled on the three. Fouled on that three shot. Was that Lucius over there? Yes, it was. That's his second.
And what you like about this play, if you're Kansas, is they ran a play to get Ben McLemore going. Off a screen, off an inbounds play, and he's going to get a chance to go to the foul line. Now this is a designed play to get McLemore an open shot off a screen. Take a look. He's going to come. Good screen by Withey. Lucius playing zone. Gets out there. You see him, gets him on the arm. I thought
it's a little ticky-tack, isn't it?
Yep. I tell you, you don't want to disrupt the shooter's rhythm. If you hit him, I think you got to make that call. I thought at Oklahoma State, Brent, this young man was very, very passive, especially late in the game and in overtime.
Up by 4 now. 18-18. Lucius off the dribble, and Johnson defends it. Crowd wanted the foul at the other end. Stab takes the pass, and they work it back outside. Niang knocks down the three ball. What a huge, huge three ball by George Niang, the freshman.
And once again, he put Withy in no man's land. Withy wasn't sure how far out the stretch.
Young on a drive, left hand, knocks it down. And Young has been a force here tonight. Working on double digits of 10 points, and the foul goes against the Jayhawks here.
Now, one of the reasons Kevin Young has gotten loose is because his man is not guarding him. They're double-teaming Withy with him. Bill Self did a good job. Take a look at this, Brent. Look where Edgem is. So now he's Young's guy. As this man comes off, Young is really open to the rim because Edgem has been worrying about double-teaming Withy.
Very big foul. That's number three on Young. He is off the floor right now. And the freshman, well defended, into Withy's hands. Hit past Rutherford, and he lost control. Iowa State down three, 17-29, but they get the ball back on the turnover.
Well, Niang went right at Jeff Withy. He wanted a foul. So did Fred Hoiberg.
Clyburn's three ball, yes! Ties it at 48.
Danger zone for Kansas.
Bill Self wants two down.
Look how far off they're playing Ellis.
Rutherford the three, yes! Jayhawks regain the lead.
You know, Travis Rutherford missed his first 11 threes of the season. Since then, over 50%.
Lucius comes back. He's fouled by Johnson. That's number three on Johnson. Young and Johnson each have three fouls now. So Tharp will replace Johnson. That puts both Young and Johnson, two of their veteran players, on the bench now at the 16:45 mark. Something to keep an eye on now will be the foul trouble as Lucius knocks it down. Now you see that Tharp, who checked in, he has two himself. Withy with a pair.
You know, Brent, I asked Fred Hoiberg yesterday why Corey Lucius has played so well in the last month, and he said when he first became eligible, he was trying to show everybody that Michigan State made a mistake. Now he's just playing basketball.
Ellis knocks it down. Very fine freshman Perry Ellis. You're going to see a lot of him over in Lawrence and on the road in the Big 12. He'll become a leader of this team in the years ahead.
Oh, mercy.
Oh, let's go alley-oop and have it go in the hoop. Even Lucius is smiling. Oh, look what I found. Here comes McLemore, pick and roll, gets in. The screen, the crowd wanted a foul on Withy. Still upset. Other end, Rutherford makes the steal. Coming back now is Tharp. McLemore on the attack. Loose ball, scramble. Cyclones get a timeout. Timeout is called as they go for the loose ball, and Hoiberg not happy with the officiating. Pulls the team out away from the sideline right now.
Watch this, Brent. It's like, no, don't throw that pass. Oh, great shot.
Jayhawks lead it by two. They've shot 53.8% here. Now, if we take a look at tonight's Wendy's wooden watch, three Big 12 players are in contention for Big 12 Player of the Year. There they are, Ben McLemore, Jeff Withy, of course, with Kansas, and the fine freshman, Marcus Smart, down in Stillwater with Oklahoma State. So here we come now. Lucius and the Cyclones. Battles out, one and done. Ellis almost had his pocket picked by Clyburn. Dart brings to the attack. Here's Withy and low back now. Dart penetrates, drives. Withy on the drive. Offensive foul. Withy's third foul. So that puts Young, Johnson, and Withy three of the four seniors who start for Bill Self with three fouls apiece.
Now drive by Tharp. Take a look. There's the dish. Does Niang get back over? Oh, it's close. It's close. I don't know.
ESPN College Basketball available live anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone at WatchESPN.com and the WatchESPN app.
Now, Iowa
One of the
State...
toughest calls in all of basketball is charge or block. And it did not appear that the man under any circumstance got there in time as Withy picks up a very tough third foul here, Fran.
Well, it's always easy when we have replay, Brent, but we kind of felt he didn't get there, and it certainly looked like Jeff Withy is going to be saddled with that third foul.
So three veteran Jayhawks, and the Jayhawks have gone young, Fran.
Three freshmen out there right now for Bill Self.
Here's Niang spinning, blocked and out of bounds, but Trailer with a fine block. Schooled that freshman.
Well, this is a good opportunity for Niang to get that ball inside as long as Withy's out.
They trailed by two, 14-56, Big 12. Kansas needs a win to stay deadlocked with Kansas State for the lead in the conference. Babb steps out, three, yes, Cyclones. 56-55.
Chris Babb has been red hot the last month of the season. Always gives you great D, really providing a lift from deep.
That is 10 successful three-point field goals. 10 tonight for the Cyclones. And this foul goes against Iowa State. So for the ninth time in their last 10 games, 10 plus free throws. They lead the NCAA and made three pointers, not free throws. Let me correct myself. That's in three pointers, of course.
That's part of the reason I think Fred Hoiberg was such a great shooter. He's brought that three-point philosophy to his offense here at Iowa State.
Ellis makes it in. As far as Iowa State is concerned now, Edgem with three will have to take a seat. So we've got three fouls.
You mentioned those coaches that Fred Hoiberg was influenced by. How about this? Larry Brown, Larry Bird, Flip Saunders, Kevin McHale, Tim Floyd, Johnny Orr. Pretty good.
Indeed. Tim Floyd, of course, had coached here at Iowa State also. And by the way, as we watch the freshman here first spin inside, blocked out of bounds, and that's a foul on Trailer. He'll come to the free throw line. The freshman. Birthday greetings not only to Tim Floyd, who's celebrating a birthday here today, but Billy Packer, our old colleague. Fran, we want to send along best wishes to the two of them. Billy, 73 years young, and Tim Floyd, 59. Tim, of course, now coaching again down in Texas.
Yep. Of course, I read Mark Packer's tweet today as he thanked, as he wished his dad a happy birthday. Mark has that radio show and Sirius.
Love to listen to that as we drive across the state of Montana, my friend.
You can't get that AM station out of Bozeman?
Yeah, it's a little tough sometimes in the mountains. There we come now. 57-58. The Jayhawks trail it by a point. They're favored by about that, too. Even though Iowa State's won 22 straight, and that shows you how tough the Jayhawks can be. Rutherford knocks down the long ball, and they lead at 60-58.
Well, he's a senior, Brent. Without Withy on the floor right now, he does not mind taking over.
Here's McGee off the bench.
Rutherford got caught watching the drive, and you can't leave McGee.
Just what we expected, folks. Crowd up here at the Hilton Coliseum. 1-point lead. Cyclones so tough to deal with at home. And Kansas wants a timeout. So we have talked about the win streak. And Fran, I know you'll know the answer to this. There are the longest win streaks. You know, it's tough to deal with that South Dakota State at home, my friend.
Oh, the Jackrabbits are tough. Yeah, absolutely, the Jacks.
Scott,
it's indeed Marquette second, and there's Iowa State looking for 23. I know you know the answer to this, so I'm going to ask you.
Go ahead.
Last road team to win a game here in Ames is.
You are stumping me.
Come on.
You're stumping me.
All right, here we go. I'm going to give you a hint.
Okay.
No longer in this conference.
Missouri.
Attaboy.
There you go.
You got it.
Yep.
Well, early last year.
That was a good Missouri team that came in here.
They were.
Yep. And by the way, South Dakota State, Nate Walters, a terrific player. He'll be in the NBA. 6'4
really?
Guard.
Yep. Yes.
6'4 guard. I think he had 53 in a game this year.
There's a great crowd in here, Frank.
Yeah,
we've been hearing so much about it. It's been fun to be here and talk to the fans. And you know, all across America, one of the beauties of college basketball is when you come to these small towns and how they support their basketball teams. It's just, it's part of Americana, and it's what makes the tournament so great. Relaford now with that three ball for the Jayhawks. Niang with the rebound. Here's Lucius. McGee spins it over to the corner. Attacking Niang. Oh, he's an aggressive, fine-looking freshman that couldn't finish that time. And the Jayhawks looking for the lead. He traveled. Iowa State basketball.
Now, as much as Iowa State loves the three, I would go inside the Niang right now. He knows how to get himself fouled. And I mentioned earlier, playing against Nerlens Noel every day, he knows how to score over bigger guys.
Fran, where is Niang from?
He's from Methuen, Massachusetts. And he's a late bloomer, Brent. He really developed in high school. Look at this.
Oh, wow. Mickey scoring again. He knocks down another three ball. That's four threes. He's 4-5 from three-point range and 14 points for the Cyclones. Ellis, the freshman, comes back the other way. Got it back. And we've got a foul that's going to go against Iowa State.
Well, Tyrus McGee, we mentioned small town guy, Stringtown, Oklahoma, JUCO transfer. If you haven't followed Iowa State this year, you probably don't know much about him, but this is a given on every night, his ability to knock down threes from behind the arc. This is not a one-time occurrence. It's a regular affair.
Ball out of bounds on the foul call. And it goes over. Turn it over on the inbounds pass. 13 turnovers on the Jayhawks here tonight. Johnson and Withy and Young, all three of the Jayhawks play with three fouls, are on the floor now for Coach Self.
Look at this score, Brent, 64-60, and we got 12 minutes to go. Both teams efficient.
Wyburn's cut off. Here's the hot hand. Relaford tightens up. Clyburn off the drive, gives it back now. Booker steps out, brings Withy with him. Five on the shot, they've got to hurry. Lucius goes on with Withy, two, left hand, no. Edgem tried to get back into it, and there was a shot clock violation. So we've got a stoppage. 11:48. Cyclones up by four. Good one in Ames.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go.
Davis with you in the studio on ESPNU, Villanova and Seton Hall tie game. Look at this nifty cut by Mook Yeru. Book from Pinkston. Yeru getting close to a big double-double, 8 points and nine rebounds, 49-45. Jay Wright's team has the lead. Marquette a winner, so too is K-State. Now they lead the Big 12, Brent.
64-60 here as Kansas brings the basketball up. Tharp sets with a deep three. No, rebound by Iowa State.
Anthony Booker's done a good job in the paint tonight, both offensively and defensively, to transfer from Southern Illinois.
Clyburn puts it on the deck. Johnson cut him off, and he comes back outside. Tough defense here by the Jayhawks. Inside, McGee couldn't get it, and with the Yanks off the rebound, and here's Tharp. Rutherford attacks. And
well, that's basket interference.
That's what I thought. Yeah. It was a foul. The two officials now are conferring. O'Neal and Whitehead are talking about it.
What they're doing, Brent, is they're determining who interfered, gold or blue. The monitor at the top of the at center court. Iowa State fans thinks that it was Kansas.
And that's the signal. I saw a very good piece of officiating, and in this particular instance, they should be able to go to the monitor. There is no reason in college basketball not to be able to go over to the monitor, but I saw something. I'm not going to tell you which one, but one of them looked up, saw the replay up above, and they made the correct call.
Well, Kevin Young yanked on that net.
And we've got a foul, blocking foul. They pick off on the screen, so it will go over now. Iowa State with a four-point lead. The Jayhawks with the basketball. We've got five players, three fouls apiece, three of them on the Jayhawks. Kansas tonight with 13 assists, but 13 turnovers. Nine assists, Iowa State, and six turnovers.
Gonna go inside here.
And here is with it. Put it down on the drive, kick back outside. Tharp off the deck, back now to Rutherford. Rutherford, long ball, three is good. And it pulls Kansas to within one.
Travis,
15.
He could not make that shot consistently for much of his first 3 years. He's really worked on that.
Lucius comes right back with a three for the Cyclones. No. And now the Jayhawks can regain the lead with their veterans on the floor. Crowd wanted Traveler. Rutherford gives it up now to Tharp. High pick for Young. Starts with the ball on the deck. Johnson works the right baseline, has to kick it back outside to the corner, gets it back from him, knocks down the three. What a nice play.
Terrific ball movement, and all because that Iowa State defense very concerned with the inside.
And the Johnson three puts the Jayhawks back up by two. Edgem on the drive. Loose ball, scramble, picked up by Lucius.
Uh-oh.
Three ball, McGee! Yes! Can't stop him. That's five threes tonight and 17 points for the game.
People around the country are saying, who? They know him in this building.
Johnson has to send it far over to Tharp. Double team on the ball. And a foul is going to be called. Well, that's Lucius.
Watch how McGee gets loose now. A lot of action. Ball on the floor. Nobody picks up Tyrus McGee. And that is a drink of water for that young man. Look, and you see how he's been right up there in some good company. James Sutherland, Devontae Gardner, Phil Forte.
Lucius picks up his third foul of the game. And so Paolo back on the floor for the Cyclones here. Johnson rattles out. Iowa State basketball. Paolo brings it up. Boo Boo Paolo from right here in Ames played on a terrific high school basketball team. Long ball, no good. Into Rutherford's hands. Niang missing that time. Looking for the lead. Young shoots for it. Got it.
Now you're asking why is he so open? They've just decided to let him shoot that shot.
McGee right back. Not this time. Wickie with the rebound. 16 lead changes here tonight as the Jayhawks go up by one on that Young field goal moments ago. Tharp loads up with it. Gets it back, moves to Johnson. Here's Tharp, he's open. Not this time. Into Edgem's hands, and the Cyclones will come down trying to change the lead for the 17th time if they can.
Elijah Johnson now on McGee.
Down comes alive at the right time. Chris Bam, the senior. 70-68, 729, 17th lead change. This setting is as good as advertised. Let's talk about Hilton Magic. Let's ask the fans about what happens here in Ames.
It's a special place. I truly think that Hilton Coliseum is the most underrated arena in the country.
Well, Hilton, the way it's built, it just kind of shakes.
All of these people representing our college and our Cyclones
make this as a miserable of a place for opponents as we possibly can.
It's Fred Hoiberg. He had the magic, it left for a little bit, and now he brought it back.
True, and yes, I do believe in Hilton Magic.
I wouldn't trade it for any place else.
We're back, and it is hard to get a good seat here. 14,376. And we've got standing room here tonight. Folks, that's Paul Rhodes. That's the football coach. And it's tough for the football coach to get down close to center court. That's how tough the tickets are here at Ames.
He beats Oklahoma, he'll get a good seat, Brent.
And McLemore's short on that shot. That is true. If he can pick off the Sooners and maybe if Sooners and Longhorns, they'll put him right in the front row.
He'll be with us. Hey, how about what the job Johnny Orr did here?
Oh,
he
amazing.
Really got it going.
Niang on the drive, and Withy just picked up number four. That's a huge call. Number four on Jeff Withy.
The crafty Niang, they set this up to isolate Withy, hoping that he could get to the lane, get a good look, or just as good with his fourth foul.
Got his arm. Hilton Coliseum on the Iowa State campus. The students have been lined up all day outside, and it is now packed to the rafters and rocking. The Cyclones have won 22 straight at home, but they badly want number 23. The Kansas Jayhawks are in town. It's game time in the Big 12 on Big Monday. That is for sure. No vacancy here, folks. Not an empty seat in the house. First Big Monday in Ames, Iowa since 2006. And the football coach up there in the rafters enjoying this one. Bill Self trying to win his 500th game as a college coach, and he's got his hands full here tonight.
Bill Self is 7-2 in this building.
And one of the twos came last year.
That's exactly right. Royce White was terrorizing the Jayhawks and the rest of the Big 12.
I am very impressed with Niang, the way he plays. Niang, he's so intelligent, Franny. As I watch him, he's more like a sophomore or a junior, the way he plays the game.
Well, you hate to use the term old school, but if you talk about Boston, the Tommy Heinsohns, the Don Nelsons.
Yes, that is old school, my friend.
That is old school. But he's got that below-the-rim crafty game.
That's true.
I was going to throw Jumbo Jim in there, too.
Well, how about Larry Bird? Nobody played crafty ball any better than Larry. All right, 72-68 now. Cyclones lead this one. And I'm telling you, Ellis is playing a good game here tonight. You can just see the maturity in Perry Ellis, the freshman from Wichita.
Well, he's got the green light, and Bill Self wanted him earlier in the year to be aggressive. Every time we see him, he attacks the basket.
What a great pass by Niang to McGee. What a pass that was.
Set up out of the timeout. NBA style.
No question. Johnson penetrates, fades, and he's on the free throw line. Drew the foul. Nice power move there by Elijah, and then fading to the baseline.
Take a look at this little back cut all set up out of the timeout. Look at the finish on the other side of the rim. Talk about Larry Bird.
and passing, huh?
It's absolutely. You know, I know Hoiberg's nickname here is the mayor. He loves being in this town. His family loves it. But I'm here to tell you, some NBA teams are going to come knocking on his door. This is a wonderful coaching job that we're watching here over the years, and so calm and poised. Folks, he was one of the best spot-up shooters I ever watched. It was catch and shoot with him. And he was remarkable, and that's why he had that long, long career.
Well, you know what you tell people, Brent, when you've been in the NBA for 10 years and worked for the guys that he played for, 100 games a year, 200 possessions a game. He's seen a lot of basketball. By the way, he was a first-team academic All-American.
And a heck of a football player.
That's right.
Tom Osborne thought he had him coming to Nebraska. Stanford took a crack at him. Dab off the dribble, going to attack with the left hand. He's on the free throw line.
This is what makes Iowa State so tough. You have to play the three-point line, but then it opens up that dribble drive opportunity for these guys. Bab attacked the rim with that muscular frame.
Just the way Hoiberg has changed things up, calmly over there on the sideline, watching where he's got an advantage, then the disadvantage, moving and doing things against Withy. It's been fun to watch here. And this building is as good as you told me it was.
It's one of my favorite places to come in the country. I always say nice is in the DNA of the people of Ames.
No question. Knocking it down to 4-point cyclone advantage. And now here come the Jayhawks. Withy is up. He'll be checking back in soon. Johnson on the dribble. Young gets it inside now. Ellis on a turnaround, a little bit short. One and done. Didn't quite get Withy in soon enough.
Now the question is for Iowa State, who do you exploit? But they're certainly going to spread it.
Lucius fires three ball. Yes! Young man who went for a Final Four with the Spartans of Michigan State. Knocks down a killer three. It's a 7-point advantage. ESPN's Journey to the Tourney season-long spotlight on games that will impact the tournament. And folks, here's one Saturday night that Fran, I know you and I are going to keep an eye on this one, because it's the rematch. And the Canes are coming off a tough loss at Wake Forest. They go back to Duke, back to Cameron. The Canes fell to number 5, and Duke moves up to 3. So much at stake in that game when we talk about 1 and 2 seeds. Here's what Joe Lenardi sees right now. Indiana, Duke, Gonzaga, and Florida, the ones are right there lurking. And the top-ranked number 2 is Miami. So that's just a huge game Saturday.
You know, I don't care about the seeds. I care about how Mike Krzyzewski is going to get that team ready after the beating they got in Miami.
Johnson dumps it out of Young. Rutherford's three ball. No, Withy couldn't get it. Niang had position, and he kept Withy away. Crowd wanted, they wanted Withy out.
Withy was smart. He made a passing try at that rebound, but not aggressive.
And Niang's going to drive on him and kick over to the corner now. Three ball, no. Into Withy's hands, trailing by 7. Needs something to happen here, and Johnson takes it in for a driving layup.
Well, what a sweet move by Johnson. He went behind his back. I think it was a McGee that tried to steal it.
They need to get McLemore going. He's only 2 of 6 here tonight. Hit all 3 of his free throws. A 7-point game. Remember, he lit him up with 33 in Lawrence. Niang off the front of the iron. And Johnson's going to come again on him. Hit Withy. And Withy finishes. Now it's back to 3 and a timeout by Hoiberg. Quickly a timeout he calls.
Now when you live by the 3, you can die by it. That time they come up empty to Cyclones. Long rebounds allowed Kansas to get out and run and get a couple easy baskets.
So Iowa State twice here tonight, Fran, has been able to build a 7-point lead. first time the Jayhawks came back and got the lead at the halftime. And now they've moved back to within three. As we take a look at Kansas Big 12 tournament history, only in March. And it's brought to you by Bud Light. And it is a remarkable history. All-time 30-7, 8-1 in the championship games. They've won five of the last seven Big 12 championships. Eight straight regular season titles in here. And they got their hands full with the Wildcats of Kansas State, who right now at the moment are a half game ahead of them as they beat Texas Tech here earlier tonight. And so the Jayhawks on defense right now. Iowa State with the ball and the three-point lead. We move inside of four. McGee guns a three after the tie ball and knocks it down. What a shooter. Six three balls here tonight. He has 22 points for the game.
I don't think he's hit the rim. I'm not surprised. I've seen this.
Young puts it on the deck. And a foul is going to be called against the Cyclones as Edgem has fouled out. So he is the first of our players to foul out. So 16 threes tonight, and that is the season high for the Cyclones, and six of them by McGee. What a shooter.
See how Jeff today was going on ESPNU. Villanova and Seton Hall. Villanova among the last four in, according to Joe Lenardi. Oh, look at Javon Pinkston Hughes. Not only the pass fake, but the bank shot. Not really that graceful, but Nova up by four late.
Young is on the free throw line for Kansas. Kevin Young with a dozen points. I'd edge him fouled out, and Cyclones are going to miss him on the glass. He's a leading rebounder tonight. Seven rebounds, had two putbacks early in this game. That's the only two field goals. But they will miss his muscle on the glass here for the last 3.5 minutes.
It's going to be interesting because this is a small Iowa State team. Withio will have an advantage inside. Iowa State will double team him and someone will get an open jump shot.
The lead is five, and McLemore in the first game with 33 against Iowa State. Only 7 points here tonight. McGee coming again. Not this time. Clyburn, and no foul is called. Kansas basketball down by five.
Freddie Hoiberg riding the hot hand of McGee.
Johnson wants Withy. Back to Tharp. Elijah Johnson's been outstanding. And one. Beautiful drive by Elijah.
Well, this is all set up because that Iowa State defense must collapse on Withy. And once that ball was kicked out, they spread the floor, gave Elijah Johnson room to drive. There's the ball movement. There's the drive. Little bump from behind.
A 19-point game for Elijah Johnson, who is so much more comfortable when he's the two guard as he has been most of this game with Tharp operating the point. Inside of 3 minutes now. Iowa State's lead, two. Niang puts it down on Withy. Withy fades with the hook, no, and Withy tracks down the rebound. Johnson again was cut off, turns it over.
Even when Jeff Withey's not blocking shots, he's certainly a presence inside as Niang tries to get that fifth foul.
Lucius has McLemore out. Pull up off the screen, and he's on the free throw line. So here comes Lucius to the free throw line, shooting a pair.
Corey Lucius has so much room to drive because all five Cyclones are spread out on the perimeter.
And a reminder now, Super Tuesday, First of 7 Eastern, number 1 Indiana takes on Minnesota, 9 Eastern. It'll be number 8 Florida visiting Tennessee, SEC, following the Big Ten matchup. That's tomorrow night here on ESPN. Now Lucius for the second free throw. Knocks them both down.
Boy, he's been really solid in Big 12 play, Corey Lucius. What an addition.
Crowd on its feet. Looking for Whitney over the top. Johnson drives left side, not this time. Iowa State basketball at the 2 minute mark, up by 4.
Now, if you're Iowa State, you can be judicious. You don't have to take the first quick one. They've been getting good looks despite the shot clock.
Lucius off the dribble, comes free, drives, pull up on Withy. Missed that time, battle for the loose ball. The Jayhawks go to the floor. McLemore had it. Off Withy, tracked down over there by Tharp. Inside of 130 now. Back to Relaford, puts it on the deck, drives in. No, battle for the rebound, scramble, and a foul is going to be called. It's against Bath. It's against Iowa State.
That started out, Devin Withy was fortunate enough not to pick up the fifth. And then the scramble. Watch the little push by Withy over the top. They should be shooting this.
Yeah, they're over the limit, aren't they? Eight fouls apiece I see over here. So that was the ninth foul. And Relaford will come up to the free throw line. Huge front end.
What a career this guy's had, Brent. 5 years, he redshirted, he waited his turn, sat behind some terrific players, but he has been rock solid as a fifth-year senior.
Trying to cut it to 2. Young will check back in at the next opportunity for the Jayhawks. He comes in, and they'll take the smaller Tharp out. Bill Self will go offense, defense now. He'll put a little more size on the floor with Young. Johnson will pick up Lucius. 84-82, coming down toward the 1 minute mark. Remember, they played an overtime game in Lawrence earlier this year.
Relaford's not going to let McGee out of his sight. Right over here in this corner.
They're letting that shot clock wind down on them. They're running out of time. They've got it back to 5. Niang steps out. Yes! What a huge save by the freshman. 87-82. Johnson quickly the attack. Relaford fires a 3 off iron. Battle rebound. Goes out of bounds. They look at each other to make the call. Going to be Jayhawk basketball down in front of Coach Self. So a school record 17 threes now as George Niang, the freshman from Massachusetts. Listen to the crowd now.
Started, Brent, from the very beginning of the game. We talked about how Fred Hoiberg's strategy was stretch the floor with his bigs, bring Jeff Withy away from the basket, the precocious freshman who struggled at times with his shooting tonight, but he doesn't struggle with his confidence.
Here you see our situation. The Wildcats having won already tonight. Jayhawks need this to stay tied. Oklahoma State snapping at everybody's heels. And Iowa State, with a win, would move to 10-5 here tonight. Great battle in the Big 12.
Yeah, now, if you're Bill Self, Brent, you're going to try to stretch this game out as long as possible. You need a 2 and a 3. You don't need them in any particular order. Once they score, they're going to press, try to steal it, and foul right away because of the shot clock.
I'll make a prediction. Big Monday will be back in Ames next year.
Without a question. They have a terrific guard coming in by the name of Matt Thomas, who is a clone of Freddie Hoiberg.
Inbounds pass to Rutherford. They must hurry offensively.
Okay, there's their chop play.
And a big three from Elijah Johnson makes it a two-point game.
They're going to steal and foul it. Got to foul soon.
And they'll put Lucius on the free throw line. Young raises his hands. He wanted to keep it away from Withy. But it... I believe that Young may have been able to convince him it was him. Is what I think happened. Withy was running back over and Self said, get back on the floor. Young raised his hand immediately.
That's good teamwork right there.
It was excellent teamwork. Yep. Now, we've talked about the threes. Here's the foul in
Boy, I thought it wasn't it Withy?
There's no question who it was on. There's no question. But anyway, the other story besides the threes is the fact that Iowa State here is 22 of 24 from the free throw line. And now they are 23 of 25.
That's a good story. Corey Lucius got sideways with Tom Izzo and found a home here in Ames. Last year it was Chris Allen. This year, Corey Lucius.
I'll tell you, Kevin Young just did one of those little things. get your hand up, get the foul, and keep the big man on the floor. I mean, Jeff Withy thinks, look what I found. I'm in the NBA tonight. I got the 6-foul rule. Here's Lucius on the line. Knocks it both down. It's a 4-point Cyclone lead, and here they come.
Again, don't need the three.
Dark. Sealed up. Johnson. Yes. Oh. Knocks the three down. Makes it a 1-point game with 12 seconds to go.
No timeouts.
And Lucius is coming back up to the free throw line. Dark fouled him.
To me. This is a variation, Brent, of the chop play that they've run to so much success. The dribble handoff, the ball screen, easy jump shot. Now, this one took a little bit longer to finish, but look how deep Elijah Johnson shoots that ball from.
So they've won 22 straight games in this building. They've made 22 consecutive free throws, and they finally miss a free throw. Will they hang on and win their 23rd straight game, or will the Jayhawks come down and win it here at the end? Remember, McLemore banked in a three to send that game to overtime in Lawrence.
Fred Hoiberg's got 2 timeouts. I don't know if he'll use them.
90-88, 11 seconds to go. Johnson's gonna drive. Loose ball, battle for it, on the floor, back to Tharp. Rattled out. Yeah. But there's a whistle, Niang is on the floor. And a foul, I believe, has been called. Niang is down.
Now here's the problem with this play. On Johnson's drive, there was an awful lot of contact. This is either a block or a charge. Take a look. That has to be called. That has to be called in that situation. Don't tell me that the players decide the game. He decided it by stepping in.
Johnson pulls the Jayhawks to within 1 point and a timeout with 4.9 seconds remaining. Let's go back to take a look at this play that Fran talked about, because it looked like Niang may have had position. You be the judge. Number 31 as he moves in here on Johnson. Now take a look.
Well, here's my point, Brent. See, I think he's solid, and I think that's a charge, but more importantly, the official must blow his whistle and call it either a block or a charge. There's no excuse for letting that much contact go on a play like that.
I thought he was set. Earlier tonight, I didn't think so.
Yep.
When they call the foul on the Jayhawks. If we go back to Lawrence, January 9th, when the Big 12 action opened up. And at the regulation, down three. McLemore off the glass. Tied it. And then Oklahoma State, Marcus Smart. Oklahoma State wins. And then there was also Texas pulling one out with a remarkable three.
Now, Brent, here's what you're thinking if you're Fred Hoiberg. If they tie it here with the second free throw, if you get the ball in bounds with 4.9, your ball handler has at least five dribbles before he has to shoot it. If they get it in cleanly, Corey Lucius can go end to end and make a play.
Elijah Johnson with a career night. He's tied his high with 26 here tonight. He's shooting for the career. Inside of 5 seconds to deadlock this game. And he does just that. 27 points. Traylor will check in and Withy will sit down.
Now that gives Bill Self a timeout right here. Let's see if Lucius can get it on the run. Five dribbles.
Brings it to the attack, fires the deep ball. We'll go again to overtime between Iowa State and Kansas.
That play at the end of regulation bothers me because you must blow the whistle from the first seconds of the game until the last seconds of the game.
So, Fran, let me go back to something that happened when Young held up his hand and it was Withy who committed the foul. Could the officials have gone over to the table if Fred Hoiberg and the Iowa State coaches had said, you got to take a look, you got the wrong man with the foul?
No. Calling a foul is a judgment call, so it's not reviewable according to the rules. Scoring, timing issues, a flagrant foul. Late game scoring situations, but not a foul because that's a judgment call. My problem is that there was a play at that end that decided this game, whether it was a block or a charge, and it did look like a charge, that they just didn't blow the whistle, and you cannot do that.
So then when the young man was on the floor, they called it when they were tangled up there by the baseline. They finally blew the whistle.
Exactly.
Let me take a look at this again. And Niang is still complaining about this.
See,
there's the reach, and this foul went to Young. Now take a look here at Niang.
See, that's textbook to me. And even if you think it's not a charge, it's a block, but you got to call one or the other.
And then the end of the game, of course, Lucius fired up a tough three. So as we go into overtime, keep in mind that Kevin Young and Jeff Withy, four fouls apiece. Edgem has fouled out for Iowa State. And Holly, what did Coach Hoiberg have to say?
Well, he told his guys that all five guys have to rebound. Remember, their best rebounder, Big 12's best rebounder, Melvin Edgem, is out, fouled out. He said, we got to keep being aggressive, guys. We are not going to let them steal it. Not this time. This is our house.
Withy controls the tap. The Jayhawks with the first possession of overtime. McLemore. And here's Rutherford.
Well, they tried to get McLemore going, couldn't do it.
Johnson, spinning move, career night, puts the Jayhawks ahead. 29 points for Elijah Johnson here tonight.
Johnson and Relaford, the two seniors, have carried this Jayhawk team on the road.
Niang kicks back outside and then a drive by Clyburn for the field goal. We're tied at 92. 92-92.
You can tell Withy was cautious on that drive, Brent. He's living on borrowed time.
He's living on bonus time.
Yeah, exactly.
Here comes. Here's Relaford. Withy wants it. Niang trying to hold him out. Withy's going to back him down and kick back outside. Johnson driving again for his 31-point night. Elijah Johnson, a career game here in Ames.
That's a young man people thought would transfer when he was a sophomore, not playing much. Stuck it out.
Niang back, not this time. Kevin Young rebounds. Now the Jayhawks can go up by a couple of field goals. Relaford. Here's Johnson again, getting away from Lucius, and this is doubled, and they get back to an open Relaford, and he knocks the three down. It's a 5-point advantage here. 97-92 overtime, Jayhawks.
Clutch play by the seniors. Been there before.
Now desperate for a field goal. Not this time, and into Withy's hands. The Jayhawks in control. Bill Self closing in on victory number 500.
And they'll spread it out here and go pick and roll and take what the defense gives them now.
Johnson jumps it back out to Relaford. Withy steps out high, and they knock some time off that clock. Elijah, are you kidding me? 34 points for Elijah Johnson. His greatest game as a Jayhawk. It's 100-92.
Well, this is a guy that played very little, Brent, his first 2 years. People expected him to transfer, and he said, I'm a Jayhawk for life. Helped him get to the Final Four, and now as a senior, through the struggles, has started to play the best basketball of his career. He is on fire.
And Holly, Coach Self has not always been happy about Elijah's play this year either.
Well, he went through a difficult stretch when Kansas was in that 3-game losing streak. In fact, after one game, Coach Self said in the media, we don't have a point guard right now. I've been to practices where he was hard on Elijah, but Elijah told me, I've just kept my head up through all of this. Guys, he had been shooting poorly in Big 12 play. He had more turnovers than assists in Big 12 play, but somehow tonight he's finding his own magic here in Hilton Coliseum.
He is a wonderful two-guard. And when Tyshawn Taylor moved on to the NBA, they asked him to move over to the point, and he tried very hard to involve everybody. But you can see tonight what his great strength is. That's as a scorer.
Absolutely, Brett. And he came in the last three games, 12 of 24. He's picking up where he left off. By the way, as a two-guard, 7 assists tonight.
Unbelievable. What a performance by Elijah Johnson. 100 points for the Jayhawks. Three balls for the Cyclones tonight. But what they need now is number 18 and 19. They need the long ball. The crowd about as quiet as they've been here tonight.
Now, if you're Iowa State, you must speed this game up. They obviously have the capability of shooting that ball. But Kansas has a very athletic group on the floor right now with Withy as the centerpiece defensively.
So Lucius brings it up. Niang steps out. And here comes McGee. And he is off iron, but Clyburn got the rebound back, going to put it on the deck. Going to come on Young. Driving inside. And a foul is going to be called. And now Jeff Withey has it. Let me check this. Kevin Young.
If Young got him first on the drive, and then Withey cleaned it up.
Already. It's those two back and forth.
Yeah.
Who's going to get the foul?
Now, there'll be a lot of consternation after this game among the Cyclone fans, coaching staff, when they realize what's happened with Withey, as you mentioned.
The Big 12 office. We'll take a look at this.
I just always have a pride. You know, these guys have tried hard, done a good job, but I've been in a situation as a coach. You blow the whistle from start to finish. That nonsense about letting players decide the game is, the guy steps in to take a charge, and he's made a good defensive play.
So Kevin Young has fouled out. And Clyburn with the clock stop comes up to that free throw line, and this is an opportunity for Iowa State now to edge a little bit closer here and then look for the defensive stop.
You think Bruce Weber and the Kansas State Wildcats are at Old Chicago tonight eating a little pizza, maybe watching this ball game, huh?
Now checking in is Paolo for Kansas State. They trail it by 7. 1 of 2. Full court press coming up. 1:46. Withey is fouled. Traveling is the call. Ball goes back. Golden opportunity here for the Cyclones.
Now, if you score, you can set that pressure up again. If you score a 3, you may not have to foul and just make this a possession game.
Clyburn will bring it across. Foul is called. Back on the free throw line. He was 1 of 2, remember, last time. Get this down to a 2-possession game here.
I think if he makes these 2, Brent, and they set up that pressure, they don't necessarily have to foul. That shot clock is going to be 4 or 5 more possessions.
Pulls him to within 6. Now it's a 5-point game. Paolo comes back.
Like they're trying to get Corey Lucius off the floor.
Relaford looking for an open man. And timeout was called. Johnson had broken wide open at the other end of the floor.
What was that, 5?
Did not get it off in time, right?
Well, it looked like a long count. Sometimes it's usually a quick count, so the officials may have done a good job there, but
can't believe that he's given it back to him. That's back-to-back turnovers, traveling, and a 5-second violation. Clyburn puts it down, drives inside, and this is out. He's back on the free throw line, and he can make this a 1-possession game. Back-to-back turnovers by the Cyclones here.
Well, they not only got Young and Withey out, but Kansas has been sloppy getting that ball in.
Yeah, Cyclones try to take advantage of the Jayhawks' turnovers. As the Jayhawks have turned it over, traveling, the 5-second violation. They can make this a 1-possession game. This is a very gutty comeback here by the Cyclones.
It certainly has been. And in fact, it's been a great game both ways. Kansas has done a great job to extend the lead. Right now, Brent, you're looking at 92 seconds to go. So that means if you cut this to a 1-possession game, you do not need to foul.
It's been an emotional roller coaster here tonight in Ames. You know, Jeff Withey fouled out of this game without one block in this game. That's only the second time this season. Did not have a single block here tonight against Iowa State. Ivern makes it a four, now looking to make it a three.
Tell you what, if I'm Iowa State, I keep that pressure on. Kansas has not solved it.
Could not make it a one-possession game. And Elijah Johnson winds the clock down a little bit. A 34-point night for number 15.
Chris Babb, a good defender.
Babb staying on him. 110, not fouling, just as you said, Fran, to play some tough defense. Elijah on the drive, throws it up. Battle got it back. Fresh shot clock. No, one did not hit the rim. Fires in.
Oh, no. 37 points, Elijah. The shot clock did not recycle on that. There was 1 second left.
Clyburn at the other end misses. And now with 45 seconds left and 103-96, Iowa State forced to foul.
There's so many great moments in the history of Kansas basketball. And you know what? This performance, take a look now. That ball does not hit the rim. And look at Elijah Johnson calling for the ball. And Jayhawk fans are going to remember this night. Watch the real time now. The hustle play to kick out. You know what, Brent? He not only got the rebound, he made the shot.
Absolutely. Took it out. This is the high-scoring performance of the season in the Big 12. Elijah Johnson is 12 of 21 overall. He has knocked down 6 three balls. He's hit all 7 of his free throws here tonight. Pulled down 5 rebounds. Dished out 7 assists. And, oh, the little boy wanted... One of the twins, is that unhappy up there with mom, the Hoiberg family?
Now these are great fans, aren't they, Brent?
You see the anguish.
Yep. You know, when the Jayhawks come to town, no matter where they go in the Big 12, they get everybody's best shot.
Elijah Johnson's performance is just incredible. He had 9 points at the half. He's put up 28 points in the second half and overtime.
The impressive play was the rebound to kick it out and then call for the ball to get it back.
And right? Knock it down again. The State has to hurry. Down by 8. Clyburn has it knocked away, loose, got it back over to a teammate. And now Lucius on the drive, left hand, not there. Ellis with a great job defensively. Loose ball picked up. McGee tried to get daylight. Babb will fire a deep 3. And Ellis off the deck with a big rebound. He's fouled coming up. And Bill Self is 22 seconds away from victory number 500. And it would snap Iowa State's 22 game home winning streak as the fans start heading for the exits now.
You know, Brent, we saw a glimpse of what Kansas could be in that game we did against Kansas State when Nadir Tharp was so good. This backcourt now, they're not going to start Tharp and move Johnson to the 2, but it's been very effective with Tharp coming off the bench and taking that pressure off of Johnson.
105-96. And it swells to a 10-point Jayhawk advantage with 22 seconds to go. Babb will fire a deep 3. Not there, picked up underneath. 11 left in the game, and from the corner, Jayhawks are going to head home with an overtime win. Their second overtime victory, and Elijah Johnson is going to have a 39-point game. A 39-point game. a 500 career win. .39 for Elijah Johnson. Kansas with a gut check victory. Coming up next, SportsCenter. And we'll say so long from Ames, Iowa, where the Jayhawks have won in overtime. Now let's go to SportsCenter. Scott Van Pelt and Stuart Scott. Guys,